Welcome back or to my channel. My name is Brooke for anyone that's new here. Today, as you can tell by the title of this video, I'm going to be surprising my mom. I am so excited to film this video. I'm so excited to see my mom and I'm so excited to surprise my mom. So today is January 11th. It is Saturday and my mom's birthday is Sunday, January 12th, tomorrow. And I am currently at my apartment in where I live for grad school, and it is about 3 hours away from home. So I waitress part-time on top of grad school, and today I'm on call, which basically means, like, if someone calls out to get sick, if someone's sick or calls out or can't make it to work, I have to go in. But the restaurant doesn't open till 4, and technically you have to be around until 4 just in case. So it kind of stinks, honestly, that I have to wait around just because I could be home right now. But it's okay because I have a little bit of errands to run before I leave anyway. So it kind of works out, I guess. I don't know. But so I'm literally like this right now that I do not get called into work. If I got a text right now, I would scream because I just want to go home and surprise my mom. I'm just going to give a quick little background. I'm not going to sit here and like tell you guys stories on stories about my mom or anything like that, but it just feels like it's very important for me to be home for my mom for her birthday, because it's her birthday, but also just because I feel like my mom has been going through a big transition recently. She is really experiencing the empty nest. Is it a syndrome? I don't know. The empty nest feeling that parents feel when their children's all leave, when their children leave the house. And I feel like it's been hitting my mom in like full effect just because there's 5 kids in my family. There's triplets that are 15 months older than me. And then there's me. And then there's my little sister. So the triplets are 23, I'm 22, and my little sister is 18. So my little sister's in college, so she just like officially left in summer, left my mom. And then my one of the triplets, the oldest triplet, his name is Dylan. He's my brother. And Dylan just graduated from Oswego, which is a state school in New York, with his master's, but he's staying in Oswego for the last semester of the year, so he's not there. My sister Tori, the other triplet, she lives and works on Long Island, which is where my dad lives too. And my mom lives in upstate New York. My other sister Chelsea is getting her, she's the other triplet, she's getting her master's in Australia. She has a boyfriend out there and she is there for 2 years. Oh, I, so confusing, I'm sorry, I hope you guys are following. I go to school, I just feel like it's important for the background of like, you know, it's different than just like surprising my mom for her birthday. I am getting my master's in social work at Binghamton University in Binghamton, New York. And yeah, so I'm 3 hours from home, and then my little sister goes to Oneonta. So, oh, also, my little sister has a YouTube channel. Go check her out. Her name is Brandi Chloe, and I will have it linked down below. Like, we're all out of the house right now, and my mom has been, like, sad and, like, kind of lonely because, like, she had 5 kids all there. Not that we were all there recently, but, like, I don't know. I just feel like the last one leaving is, like, boom, gone, you know? This is the plan. Okay. So, my sister Tori, the one that lives on Long Island, and my brother Dylan, they are both in upstate New York right now with my mom. So she knows that they're there. Oh, Chelsea's in Australia, so she won't be here. My little sister Brandi is in Australia visiting my sister Chelsea. So the only people that can be there, is what I'm trying to say, is my brother who's there, Dylan, and my sister who's there is Tori. So anyway, I told my mom that I'm on call today and she knows that, and that I won't know until 4 if I can come home or not. So if I don't get called in, I'm gonna call my mom on the or on the camera with you guys so you guys can hear it and tell her, like, I got called in, I'm so sorry, like, I wish I could be there, I love you. And then I'm gonna get in my car and go surprise her. So my brother and sister know about the plan, so they're praying that I don't get called in too, just so we can surprise my mom. I'm so excited, and I just feel like my mom, like, deserves a really great birthday. I feel like it's been a lot for her recently, she's been going through a lot, and like, I just want her to be happy and to have a really great day where she knows that, like, all of the love and attention is for her and on her, and that she is deserving of it. So I don't know, I just feel like everyone deserves to feel special on their birthday. So with that being said, I need to go to the bank. We'll get a card, maybe flowers if I get them right now, and I need to go to the bank. So let's go, and then we're gonna pack, and it is 11:30 right now, and we will be leaving soon. right, let's make this the best birthday ever. You guys, it is literally January 11th, and right now it is 55 degrees in Binghamton, New York. What? I mean, I'll take it. I'm literally wearing jeans and a jean, Vans and a jean jacket, and like a thin turtleneck and leggings, and it's like hot. Oh my God. I found a card. I just stopped at Walgreens because it was right next to the bank that I go to. First of all, why are cards so expensive? Like, I just paid $8 for a card, a birthday card. $8. I should have checked the price. I mean, it's a nice card, so it's okay, but like, that's just a little. I should have made my own, honestly. Why spend the money? Anyway, I really don't like the outside of the card. I think it's kind of ugly, but like, the message is really cute. So it says, "For you, Mom." I don't really like that, but it says, "Through the years, you've given me so much. You gave me advice when I needed your wisdom. You gave me encouragement when I needed a push. You gave me understanding when I needed a friend. And along with all these gifts, you've always gave me unconditional love. I can never thank you enough, Mom. And I hope that you know you'll always have my love too. The same gift you've always given me. Happy birthday." Isn't that cute? Definitely worth the, okay, maybe it's not worth the $8 because I could have ruined that myself, but it's a nice card. So I'm gonna go home right now, write on it, fill it out, get it ready, pack my bag, because it's 12 and I haven't been called in yet. And then, yeah, by 3, I'll go to the store. I might just get flowers now on my way out. So I'll get flowers, and then my gift, I already said, has been delivered today, but it has my name on the box, so I don't think she's gonna open it until I get there, which is good. Yeah, so I'm so excited. I really hope that this is going through. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. I can't wait. And we're gonna get sushi tonight, so I'm so excited. I haven't had sushi in a really long time, and I love sushi. Yum. Okay, so I will see you guys when I am heading out. Now later in the day, and it's almost 2 o'clock, and I have not been called into work, so I'm just gonna go with that I'm not getting called into work today, and I'm just gonna leave. I just called my sister Tori because she's home, and she said my mom's at the gym right now, but I don't want to call her when I'm driving because I don't want her to hear the car. So I'm just gonna try to give her a call and see if she answers. Okay, so let's see if she answers. She's gonna be so upset. Oh
my God. Your call has been forwarded.
Oh, she has her phone on do not disturb.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, what's up?
Nothing. What are you doing?
I'm at the gym.
Oh, you go, girl.
Yeah, that was my first day at the gym. Yeah.
Okay. I just got called into work. I'm so sad.
I'm sorry.
I really wanted to come celebrate with you. I feel so bad.
All right. Me too. But, you know, I understand. I totally understand. All right, I love you. I'm sorry you can't be here.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
We'll be together.
Yeah, that's true. I'm so sorry. I feel so bad.
All right, Brooke, I love you. Let me know what your plans are, and I'll leave the door unlocked for you.
Okay. Okay, I'll text you.
Hopefully I'll see you tomorrow.
I hope.
Okay, love you.
Love you too. All
right.
Bye. Bye. Oh my God, I feel bad for lying. Oh my God, I feel so bad. I feel like I'm gonna cry. I just feel bad. She was just like, oh God. She was just like on the phone. She's like, oh, okay. Like, I hope I can see you tomorrow. I feel so bad, but I shouldn't because I'm literally going right now. All right, let's go. I need to go. I'm getting like emotional. Like, my eyes are watering because I feel bad for lying about that because like, she really wanted me to come. I am going, but you know what I mean? Like, she doesn't know, and she's probably like in the gym, like sad right now. Okay, let's go. Let's go surprise her. Let's go pick up flowers. And let me fill out this card and let's go. I already packed. Let's go. Come on. Just got into my car and I just put all my bags in. Let's go. Let's get out of here. I'm so excited. My mom just texted me and she goes, oh. She goes, "You're my best buddy. Hopefully I see you tomorrow. I can't wait to squeeze you." Oh, okay. Let's go get some flowers and let's get home. Okay. Sorry about the lighting. It's getting a little dark, but that's awful. I am currently pulling out of the grocery store in my hometown. I just picked up the flowers. I ended up waiting until I got to my hometown to grab them just because I didn't want them to like not be as pretty if they were in the car for 3 hours. Cause I don't know. I was just worried. But yeah, so I just picked them up and now we're gonna head home. I am literally driving down my street and I am about to pull into my driveway. Sorry for the lighting. I just turned on like the little overhead light because it gets dark in like 10 minutes. What the heck? I literally went into the store and it wasn't that dark out. Like it wasn't dark and now it's dark out. Oh my God, okay. I'm pulling up to the driveway. I'm pulling up. Should I shut the lights off? Oh, they're gonna see the car, duh. Okay, I need to shut the lights off. Okay. Here so you can't see my car. Oh no. Okay, let's go quick before anyone sees me. Okay, I'm running. She can't see me. I'm scary. You think she knows? I filmed the whole thing.
I just go walk in your room.
Were you surprised?
Yes.
Aw, I'll show you guys the rest of the day. Happy birthday, Mom. Yum. Cheers. Woohoo. Happy birthday! What are you drinking?
So happy that
it's... No, I said, what are you drinking?
Cappuccino.
Nice.
Yummy.
Cheers. So cute. Let's vlog of Ashley.
No, I can't.
Today is my mom's birthday and we have this lovely creature with us. It's so nice. And yeah, so basically that is what we're doing. Corey and Bill and Dylan in the same clothes from last night. So right now we are out to breakfast at the Scotty Brothers, which is where I work in the summer, and we just ordered breakfast and I'm so starving. Okay, I got eggs Benedict Florentine. It looks so good. And you got the same thing. Looks good. Hello.
Hi.
Welcome back to the vlog. Right now, my mom and I are sitting in front of the lake because it's like the best view of Lake George. And we are just soaking up her birthday, right?
Right. We're having lots of fun.
Yeah. Tell them what you did for your birthday.
I went out for breakfast, so my belly is full and we're just chilling out by the water, very relaxing on a beautiful Sunday day at 50 degrees in the middle of January.
That's so weird. Who would have thought? Right. Usually I feel like the lake is frozen by now. When does it usually get frozen?
It would have been already frozen. Very yeah. strange year.
Yeah, I'll show you guys the view. So peaceful. Pilot Knob Beach, where we are. So yeah, we are going to just sit here, and then I have to leave today because I have like school stuff tomorrow and work. So yeah, we'll probably just eat dinner and then I'll go. But I'm gonna take pictures of my mom by the lake because I want a picture of her by the lake. Right?
Right.
I'm gonna make her do a photo shoot.
Oh God.
Spin around.
Yeah.
I'll caption it, "You're only as old as you feel."
You got it.
That's true though. You really are as only as old as you feel. If you feel like you're 80, then you probably act 80 and look 80. Mm-hmm. But you're not 80. That's old.
Hey, feeling good.
That's not 80.
Like I should. When in dark, I walk around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed. Never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday bed.
Thank you for joining our car sing-along. We gotta get back to driving. Bye!